Channel, man, and the beat in the intro again by T Customs, dude. Go to the link below, man. It'll take you to downloadpass.com, in which you can click on the mixtape where this beat was from and get his contact information via Twitter, dude. And if you holler at him to get some beats, tell him I sent you. But anyway, on to today's reply, and it's to that fabulous Soul Tape 3. And you know what? Mixtape here is pretty damn hot, dude. Like, out of the Soul Tape series, dude, I think this is just as good as the second one, in which the second one was my favorite one, but I definitely want to listen to it some more. Now, there was a bunch of really good stuff on there. My favorite songs to begin with were Sacrifices, You Know, That Young OG. I still fuck with that dude. And then there was a ton of very interesting things that he went about on this project. Like, first of all, he sets the example, he sets the bar on what you need to do if you're going to rap on an instrumental to make that instrumental hot, dude. Like, really, I like his version of Everything Was the Same more than fucking Drake's version. It's something rappers need to understand, man. The only times you're gonna use an instrumental is if you completely slaughter that shit, or you're just using it for practice to get your skills up. You can't use damn instrumentals to build up your buzz and shit like that no more, dude. People getting sued for that shit. Real shit, original music is just way fucking better, and it'll take you places that these instrumentals just can't do. Like, how the fuck is you gonna go to a club and perform on some fucking instrumentals? How amateur is that? Now, one thing that kinda did get to me that annoyed me a little bit is how Fabulous went out and got some production that was pretty much samples of people who sampled classic material, you did? Like on the song The Get Back, in which lyrically I like a bunch of stuff in there, like how he's getting back at Kendrick Lamar and Trinidad James on it. But musically, we've all heard that fucking sample before. Sure, they sampled it in a different manner, but ultimately, it's still a sample of classic shit. I mean, really, it just gets to me because there's so many records out there that you can sample. Why are people sampling these same exact fucking tracks that already have classic material embedded on them that everyone already remembers? It comes off feeling like a copycat type mentality, in which that's the shit that I fucking hate, instead of building your own. But overall, man, the mixtape was pretty fucking solid, dude. I definitely think if he would have dropped it a little earlier, then it could have made my top 10, man, but I would still have to listen to it some more. But I definitely recommend people to go ahead and download that one. But anyway, on to Ask Download Pass. Now, here's a message that I got on the Lecrae mixtape that I reviewed. What this chick said is, you shouldn't be cursing while you're reviewing gospel music. See, this is the thing that I don't like about church going folk. I mean, I understand you got strong beliefs and all of that, man, but where does it say in the Bible you cannot say fuck, shit, bitch, damn? This whole good Christian thing that you guys are trying to fucking run with, man, you pretty much made that shit up. You guys are some of the biggest hypocrites out there in the fucking world, dude. Y'all on that whole holier-than-thou shit. That's why a lot of them really don't like Lecrae. He's pretty much telling the truth about how he wants to wear his Jordans, want to wear his gear and shit to the church, and they won't let him in because he's not dressed up in suit. Y'all acting like we don't know the game that you sinning all fucking week to go to church to feel saved for a couple hours, then you're going back to fucking sinning. So here's some real shit for you. I'ma say whatever the fuck I want to say, because I can say whatever the fuck I want to say and express my motherfucking self. My homeboy Spaz asks, did you see that Eminem Monster video? And you know what? I did. I didn't get a chance to review it, man, but it's actually a pretty damn good video. It actually makes me like the song a little bit more than what I did from when I listened to the whole fucking album. See, the video was Inception themed, which a lot of people I don't think seen it, pretty much when he's in the elevator seeing all of the memories that he's having. That's Inception. But yet he's looking at and redoing a whole bunch of his classic videos and shit, which I like that aspect, but you see how the album was just like that though. What it seems like they did for this album, man, is they just took a look back at Eminem's old albums, made leftovers into a meal for people to buy, added one good song, which is that Rap God, and just people ate that shit up. Custom, custom, custom.